I'm sorry. Okay.
Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. I can feel His mighty power and His grace. I can hear the brush of angels' wings. I see glory on each face. And surely the presence of the Lord is in this place.
Welcome. My name is Tim Menzies, and this is my first time of doing Facebook live or any other way. And so, as you all know, those of us who travel around in gospel music are sitting in our houses just like everyone. And so we thought we would take this opportunity to come to you through one of your devices and hopefully encourage you and remind us of who's in charge of all this, even when we do not understand what's going on. The first word that God shares with us in His holy book is Genesis 1:1. In the beginning, God. If we start there, all 66 books come together beautifully. In the beginning, God created, so we know God the Father has always been there. Verse 2 of Genesis 1, the Holy Spirit hovered. So we know God the Holy Spirit has always been there. By divine inspiration, the Apostle John identified Jesus in John 1:1. In the beginning was the Word. Lets us know that in the beginning the Word already was. And we know from verses 14 and 17 of John that Jesus Christ is the Word. So in the beginning was the Word, lets us know that in the beginning the Word already was. There's never been a time when Jesus was not. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through Him all things were made. It's my understanding that all, translated from the New Testament Greek, means all, as in all. Now, even in this time of crisis, Jesus is there. And if we just look, we'll see Him. I wasn't raised in the church, and I didn't grow up hearing those verses or being exposed to those truths. And when I became born again and started looking back over my life, I saw that Jesus had been there the whole time, even when I was ignoring Him. And it led to the writing of this song, and I pray it blesses you. I was there that night in Bethlehem, and when Neil and the boys came to the moon in that tin can. At Gettysburg, Omaha Beach, and Vietnam, I heard every soldier's cry and every mama's prayer. I was there. I was there when you took your first breath, when you lit that stolen lucky strike and like to choke to death. When you were waist deep in Carter's Creek and Pastor John dunked you down in the water and raised you up for air. I was there. I'm always around. I was then and I am now, and I'll be here
when tomorrow comes. When a road comes to an end, I'm where you start again. I'm never farther than a word away. You've always got a friend. When your grandma passed, I was in that house. When your grandpa ran down the streets of gold to show her around, I was there. Then and I am now, and I'll be here when tomorrow comes. When a road comes to an end, I'm where you start again. I'm never farther than a word away. You've always got a friend. There last night on Highway 9, when you answered the phone and ran right through that stop sign. I was in the cab of that big rig in that trucker's ear, made him swerve to the right and miss you by a hair. I was there. When you're feeling alone, look up. I'm the one who answers prayers. And I'm always there.
There, especially now when we're looking for him. When God decided to bring his great Old Testament prophet Elijah home, there was no funeral. Chariots of fire and horses of fire came down and carried Elijah up to heaven in a whirlwind. I wouldn't mind a whirlwind here today in the middle of Facebook and all. Swaying low, sweet chariot, come and fold, carry me home. Swaying low, sweet chariot. Coming for to carry me home. I looked over Jordan. What did I see? Coming for to carry me home. A band of angels coming after me. Coming for to carry me home. Wing low, sweet chariot. Coming for to carry me home. Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home.
if you get there before I do. Coming to carry me home and tell all my friends I'm a coming to. Coming for to carry me home. Wing low, sweet chariot. Coming for to carry me home. Swing low, sweet chariot. Coming for to carry me home. Swing low, sweet chariot. Coming for to carry me home. Swinging low, chariot. Coming for to carry me home. Coming for to carry me home.
Swing low. Well, I'm about tired of standing up here by myself, and we're over here at Daywind Studio in Hendersonville, Tennessee, and we were doing some demos of a couple of new songs since we're all canceled from our churches, and lo and behold, one of my dearest friends and brothers in Christ was over here, and he had a bass guitar with him, and he happens to also be a member of the world-renowned Isaacs, some of the most special people and musicians, singers, writers in the world. And what I love most about them is their heart for Jesus. And I have been blessed that Ben Isaacs has produced both Christian albums that I've had. And when you get Ben as a producer, you also get a bass player and a harmony singer and an engineer and just an all-around general tall old boy is what he is. I would like to invite with honor my friend Ben Isaacs. Thank
you. Yes, sir.
And
it's hard playing to no crowd, isn't it?
Yeah, well,
it's
a little.
A lot of dead time. Do I play on this one?
I'm feeling better now. Yes, sir.
Okay.
I wanted to give this a little bit of intro.
Yes, sir. Well, first let me say it is an honor to be by your side for this, and one of the most incredibly talented musicians and singers, songwriters you'll ever hear in your life, and I don't say that lightly. And Tim, you're special, and anything that I can do to stand beside you and support you, I'm here. So.
Well, thank you. That warms my heart. If it wasn't for social distancing, I'd come over and give you a hug on your neck.
I reckon I'm corona free. Does anybody know?
We don't know. That's the part of it. But if I was going to catch it from somebody, you know, this will be you.
Might as well.
I'd come over your house.
Yes, sir.
Lay around. We read in John 3:3, Jesus says, to inherit the kingdom, you must be born again. And some of us had the privilege of sitting beside the deathbed of a loved one who's been born again. And those that do not know Jesus as their Lord and Savior and the eternal comfort that that brings may not understand how we can have simultaneously a loss and a victory. Because we know Hebrews tells us that God will send ministering angels, and that Paul says it's better to depart and be with the Lord. Mm-hmm. And the first experience I had of that was my father-in-law, who knew the Lord. He knew the Bible. He knew the scriptures and the church. He was in hospice losing a battle to cancer in the front room, but his mind was still sharp. My wife is an only child, and she was able to be there with him. And he would wake up and say things from experiences that he was having from that bed. And one time he woke up and said, "Brenda, Jesus is over there and over here at the same time." And he said it with a new sense of awe. Now, he knew that from the scriptures, that Jesus is omnipresent. But he was experiencing something in a new way, kind of an epiphany way. One time he woke up and said, "Brenda, it's beautiful over there. Why don't you go with me?" And she said, "Well, I better stay here and raise your grandson, but I'll be over soon enough." And shortly after that, he was gone. When you write songs for a living, you can start from those personal experiences, and then you try to have a story that everybody can relate to. So in this song, the singer is the grandson, and the grandfather is the one being escorted over to the other side. He was laying in that bed when I let myself in. He said, "Tell your grandma hi, boy," with a big old grin. He said, "That's my cousin Joe, Master Sergeant Mike. I kind of played along, though there was no soul in sight." Then he said, "Listen to the choir. Don't you love this song?" That's when it hit me hard. He probably don't have long. It was only me and him, as far as I could see, waiting on the end and eternity. It was written on his face. There was no doubt in his faith that even Jesus would be coming soon to that little crowded room. I thought through the years and how they went so fast. All the footballs and the baseballs and all the fish we used to catch. He asked me what was wrong when he saw me hang my head. Then he said, "Y'all please make some room here for my grandson on this bed." He put his hand on my shoulder, said, "This old world ain't all there is." Then he nodded towards a corner, said, "Go on, tell him, sis." It was only me and him, as far as I could see, waiting on the end and eternity. It was written on his face. There was no doubt in his faith that even Jesus would be coming soon to that little crowded room. One by one, folks started showing up from this side.
From wall to wall, we laughed and cried and said our goodbyes. It was written on his face, there was no doubt in his faith, and we knew even Jesus was there too, in that little crowded room. That little crowded room. That little crowded room.
I told you.
Thank you. Thank you, Ben. I've gotten where I can't read my name without my glasses. And so my wife, Brenda, she hates this string.
Yeah.
But I'm telling her it's fixing to come in. Yeah. I'm ahead of the curve on this.
Right, right.
You watch.
I know you are.
We read in Luke John 1, beginning at verse 30, Gabriel had visited Mary. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will be with child and give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever." How long, Ben?
Forever.
Forever. "His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God." The Thursday night before his Friday morning cross, Jesus told his disciples in John 14, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." John 8, he said, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness." John 14, also that Thursday night, he said, "Peace I leave with you. Peace I give you, not as the world gives." In John 10, Jesus says, "I am the good shepherd. I know my sheep, and they know my voice." Then Romans 5, verse 8, "While we were still yet sinners, Christ died for us." I find it fascinating that the only person ever to walk the earth who did not need the cross was the only one that could have gone to the cross for our sin. His perfection is what qualified him for the job. And it's what he left the glory of heaven to do. I have a new album, and the name of it is His Name is Jesus. And we were blessed with a Grammy nomination in the album category. Mm-hmm. And so every time that the nominees were listed in all the magazines, whether they were Christian or secular, it would be His Name is Jesus, a written proclamation. We know that there's power in that name. Mm-hmm. And even if someone doesn't know him, there's power in that name. We don't give him the power. It's there. Yeah. And I just loved, for those few weeks, every time I saw a magazine or advertisement for the Grammys, it said, "His Name is Jesus," which is the answer to all questions. It's the answer to what we are all going through as a country and as a world right now. His name is Jesus. I can tell you want to try.
trust your feelings. Right now you're feeling like all hope is lost. Your dreams have run aground and left you stranded in the middle of a broken heart. But there's a way out of the darkness. There's a light that never fades. There's a peace beyond understanding. His name is Jesus. There's a voice that's always calling. There's a truth to set you free. There's one who died to give us salvation. His name is Jesus. He knew the cross and Rome nails were waiting. Still he chose to be lifted on that tree. To die and rise and sit beside the Father. Making sure for you and me. There's a way out of the darkness. There's a light that never fades. There's a peace beyond understanding. His name is Jesus. There's a voice that's always called. There's a truth to set you free. There's one who died to give us salvation. His name is Jesus. Call on him. He knows your name. It's never too late to begin again. There's a way out of the darkness. There's a light that never fades. There's a peace beyond understanding. His name is Jesus. There's a voice that's always calling. There's a truth to set you free. There's a one who died to give us salvation. His name is Jesus. There's a one who died to give us salvation. His name is Jesus.
Amen.
That's great.
Amen. His name is Jesus, the answer to all questions. Well, I have on this new album, His Name is Jesus, there's also a song I had planned on recording for many months before we started that second album, a song called Walking in Jerusalem, Just Like John. And, of course, that's about Revelation 21, when the new heavens and the new earth come down in the holy city where we'll all live forever. And we were supposed to start the album in March of 2018, and March came and went, Mr. Ben, producer, and we didn't start. And I began to get frustrated, just a smidget. So then April came and went, and we still didn't start. And I began to get real frustrated. Not at Ben.
Uh-huh.
No, sir.
I've got big shoulders.
And I'm traveling around the country by myself
Frustrated.
That's right. And one of the final days of April of 2018, I was sitting in a hotel room in Forest City, Arkansas, by mm-hmm. myself, all frustrated and everything.
Mm-hmm.
And you called. Mm. And you said, hey, can you record May 14th, 2018? And May 14th of 2018 was the 70th birthday of the reestablishment of the nation of Israel. So we recorded Walking in Jerusalem just like John on Israel's 70th birthday, and I knew we were right on time.
Yes.
And it was an anointed day.
It was.
And you had, I think it was the first record you did in your new studio.
Right. Yeah. I've been in there, 2 years now, yeah. And we had, trust me, as frustrated as you were, I was the same, because I was planning on being in the studio in the 1st of March, but three or four very important pieces were on back order. Mm-hmm. So I literally was sitting there twiddling my thumbs, paying rent on a building. And, you know what? God has perfect timing, and, we got it all worked out.
Amen. Amen. And I was more comforted by starting on Israel's birthday, then I felt better about that than would have if we'd have started in March.
Yeah, wow.
You know, so it was amazing, because we wouldn't have been recording long enough to still be doing tracks.
Right, right.
By May 14th, we would have finished that part. So it was a divine timing.
Mm.
And I thought it couldn't get any better than that. And I was wrong.
Mm-hmm.
And my friend and producer, Ben, with the Isaacs, they're always playing with other gospel artists. Y'all were with the Gaithers.
Mm-hmm.
And you played it for Bill.
Mm-hmm.
And he loved it.
Mm-hmm.
And the Gaither Vocal Band sang on the record.
Yes, they did.
That's a highlight in my life.
Yeah.
And I thought, man, it can't get any better than this. And I was wrong.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I know where you're going exactly.
That's
I
exactly
promise
right.
You I
know you were there.
I was there.
And so right around those same few days, the Isaacs were planning to go to Israel in November of 2018. And you invited us, mm-hmm. me and Brenda and our son Timothy, to go with you. And it worked out, once again, divine timing. And we were all in Israel in November of 2018. The year of celebration for Israel's birthday. Mm-hmm. And we got to sing over there, and y'all let me sing with you. And we taught in the Garden of Gethsemane, of which some of those trees are 2,000 years mm-hmm. old. And we know what happened in that garden 2,000 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Something similar to what's going to happen soon.
Right.
And so... it just kept being a blessing, this walking in Jerusalem, just like John. And then the Isaacs invited me and Brenda and Timothy, along with Karen Peck, to go to Israel in June of 2020.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll see.
We'll see.
We'll just see.
That's it.
Yeah.
That's all we have.
We can't social distance on the plane, I don't think. I don't know. We might.
More room to lay down, buddy.
So we'll see. Now, as y'all can see, the Gaither Vocal Band is not here.
Right.
But we have Ben Isaacs. And I want to ask my wife, Brenda, to join us. And we have a partial vocal band. At Daywind Studio on Walking in Jerusalem, just like John. Welcome, dear. If there were people here, they would be welcoming you. Yeah.
See, I knew that's where you were going to. When I said, I know where you're going, yes. I knew you were getting her up.
That's
so
it. That's right.
That's the highlight of the song.
We have to bust up the ugly up here a little bit, you know? Yeah.
Yes, sir.
So.
Can you come stand in front of me?
Yes, social distancing part, yes. You ready, brother?
I'm waiting on you.
All right.
John, oh John, what did he say?
Walking in Jerusalem just like John.
I'll meet you there on the crowning day.
Walking in Jerusalem just like John.
I wanna be ready. I wanna be ready. I wanna be ready, Lord, to walk in Jerusalem just like John. Come broken and some come lame.
Walking in Jerusalem just like John.
By grace we come shouting in Jesus' name.
Walking in Jerusalem just like John.
I wanna be ready. I wanna be ready. I wanna be ready, Lord, to walk in Jerusalem just like John. I wanna be ready. I wanna be ready. Jerusalem just like John. One day we'll rise and shine in glory.
Walking in Jerusalem just like John.
Till then we'll sing this gospel story.
Walking in Jerusalem just like John.
I wanna be ready. I wanna be ready. In Jerusalem just like John. I wanna be ready. I wanna be ready. I wanna be ready, Lord, walk in Jerusalem just like John. I wanna be ready. I wanna be ready. I wanna be ready, Lord, walk in Jerusalem just John. Walking in Jerusalem just like 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 John.
Amen. So there.
There you go.
We just good job, Brenda.
Just kindly jumped in there, didn't we?
Oh, yes. You know, it's hard enough keeping up with the music that I have to remember all of. Tim is such an amazing singer, but with his talent comes this incredible ability to put vocal phrasing in the weirdest places you would ever imagine in your lifetime. So it's so much fun. I love singing with you, and I really am honored to be here. And I apologize for every time I'm thinking about the vocal and not mess up on the bass. I can't do both.
No, but this was impromptu.
Yes,
you
sir.
Know, we didn't really... We talked about a few things prior to this, but that's about it.
I made myself a couple cheat notes, but
that's right.
Sometimes you can't have enough cheat notes.
Yes. And with the Isaacs and all the producing you do, you have played and sung and produced probably 4,900 songs since these.
Maybe.
And so, yeah.
I still remember most of it, though.
Yes. You remember the phrasing better than I do. That's why when I've changed them.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. I apologize.
You see me staring at your lips.
I'm trying to remember what we did the first time, but that was a couple of years back. So, well, we all know that Nashville is a songwriting town, and I moved here many years ago to write songs for a living, and all the rumors you've heard about how tough it is are true. Nashville's not hoping that another songwriter moves here.
Right.
And so I used to call home, and I didn't lie, Brother Ben, but I didn't tell everything.
Mm-hmm.
And I would talk to family members or friends, and I think that they would think he's still down there, so he must be doing okay, and they would hang up and thought I was doing okay. But my mama, from 650 miles away, still had her mama radar
mm-hmm.
on full tilt. And I was always amazed at just a few words from me, she would know what was going on in the heart of her child. The first time that I read Luke 1, where the mother of our Lord Jesus was visited by Gabriel, and we read that earlier, and she was with child by the Holy Spirit, and we didn't go on to read that. She got so excited she wanted to tell her relative Elizabeth, who was also with child, we know to be John the Baptist. And when Elizabeth heard Mary's voice, the baby in Elizabeth's womb leaped for joy. Elizabeth did not need to see John's face to know the heart of her child. Mm-hmm. And we know that's a miracle, but I'm convinced that loving mothers know the heart of their children because it's a godly connection.
That's good.
So many years ago, a friend of mine named Tony Hazelden and I wrote this song, and a group called Shenandoah had it out. And it takes more than one song to have a writing career, but I was able to put some bologna on the mayonnaise sandwiches in the cooler in the back of my pickup. So I want to always thank Shenandoah and Tony Hazelden for this song that kind of started things as a writer called Mama Knows. Me and Jimmy Crowder and a single cigarette, crouched down in a stall out in the barn, and three puffs later we were sick as we could get, praying we'd get better before we got home. She saw me coming through the back door screen, and I knew the minute that she looked at me, Mama knows, Mama knows. Sometimes I think she's got a window to my soul, Mama knows. Even when I think it doesn't show, Mama knows. Me and Becky Johnson ankle deep in ocean waves, pants rolled up and hearts out on our sleeves, both feeling more than either one of us could say. That first love left the sweetest memory. 15 and shy, I didn't tell it so.
Same.
Now how is it Mama never has to be told? Mama knows, Mama knows. Sometimes I think she's got a window to my soul, Mama knows, Mama knows. Even when I think it doesn't show, Mama knows. I wasn't home when Mama passed away, didn't get to say I love you, but I've got this feeling, Mama knows, Mama knows. Sometimes I think she's got a wind to my soul, Mama knows, Mama knows. Even when I think it doesn't show, Mama knows, Mama knows, Mama knows.
I'd like to have a chance to redo that one.
No, I'm just kidding. this whole live thing ain't all it's cracked up to be.
Man, when you get people to look at you and respond, and sometimes you can hide some of that stuff, but when you're
that's right,
man,
and you look out at somebody out there smiling, and it kind of makes everything okay.
Yeah, so, or laughing at you, one
laughing
or
one or the other. So, but it's fun hanging out with y'all and meeting up at the studio.
Yes, sir.
You know, with me changing the phrasing on all the songs and everything, it's because I'm always by myself. Brenda goes with me sometimes if I'm close.
Mm-hmm. And I sing Ben's part.
Yeah. And she sings Ben's part. And so then when Ben's here singing his part.
It's all good.
Yes.
It's all good. Yeah. Sometimes it's, you know, I think honestly, I think when you want, people just want to know that you're real. Yes. And we do mess up, and some of us mess up more than others. But, you said thank you to Daywind, and I wanted to say a special thank you to Daywind for hosting something like this, and Ed Leonard, and the guys that are Micah and Justin, and the guys that are behind the scenes that make all this happen, and, you know, they know who they are, and we're grateful.
Yes. So. Yeah. And if they weren't here, we'd be lonely and silent.
Yeah.
It wouldn't just be lonely. Yeah. Yes. Now, this part, Ben.
Yes, sir.
You know how we have friends who can tell stories and tune all at
right.
the same
yeah.
time?
Yeah, you can't.
I'm not one of those. Yeah.
Well, you're doing a pretty good job.
Yeah.
Except you're tuning the wrong peg.
Yeah. Just kidding. Other than that.
Yeah. See, I could have said my bit about Ed Leonard and all them right now while you tuned.
Well, that, but we didn't know.
We didn't know.
Because this year's...
I didn't know you were out of tune.
This is impromptu and everything. And so, yeah, Justin and Micah ran all the wires and whatnot. If old Roadhog was here, he'd have something to say about that.
Oh, right. There's more cameras and iPads in this room than I've ever seen in my lifetime.
They're everywhere.
I told Brent, I said, man, this is a lot.
I hope they're getting a good angle on me.
They've got all of them, so right. one of them has to be.
You know what? If you get enough of them, I might be tall as you.
Yeah, well, that's true.
We'll need more than these.
I love Jeff Easter's story. He said some woman came up to him at the product table and said, boy, Jeff, you look like you've put on some weight there. And he said, well, ma'am, you know those TV cameras do tend to put some weight on you, like 10 pounds or so on you. He said, man, she said to him, well, Jeff, how many of them cameras did you have on you?
She ain't going to let him up.
No.
Yeah. We do have honest meetings at that product table.
Yes, sir.
Yep. Yes, sir. Yeah. You never know what's going to happen there. I think this song is especially appropriate now, but I've thought that ever since we wrote it, so I think it's just one of those songs. We read in James 4, beginning at verse 13. Now listen, you who say today or tomorrow we will go to this or that city, spend a year there, carry on business and make money. Why, you don't even know what will happen tomorrow. What is your life? You are a mist that appears for a little while and then vanishes, a mist. That isn't a whole lot, is it? Instead, you ought to say, if it is the Lord's will, we will live and do this or that. As I said earlier, I end up driving around the country all the time alone and a lot of time to think. And I got a call that a friend of mine had been diagnosed, and he had not been sick, and said that he had 3 months to live. And this friend of mine, I know that he knew who Jesus is, but then he would have periods where he would disappear for 2 or 3 months at a time, and nobody hear from him, and went through 2 or 3 families that way. And then he would come back, and things would get kind of normal again. And so when I got this news about him having 3 months, I was concerned about his salvation. And I wanted to talk to him, but I didn't want to make him angry to where he wouldn't talk to me in his last 3 months. And so I was driving around the country thinking about the exact words I would use. And the diagnosis was wrong, and he lived 2 weeks and died. And so I didn't get to talk to him. And we know that my friend's salvation did not depend on me. And if the Lord had someone that he wanted to talk to my friend, he would have urged someone else that didn't drive around thinking about it. And I pray that he called out to the Lord at the end. And I hope to see him again on high. But I learned from then on, when I get a nudge or a call, I don't wait around. I just say a quick prayer and trust the Lord to put his word in my mouth. Mm-hmm. And that led to the writing of this song. We tend to think time's on our side, and we'll set things straight when the time is right. But we can't see around the bend, and we don't know when the road will end. I'll get to that later, is a promise we can't make. Could be sometime tomorrow, it's just one day too late. If you wanna say I love you, don't wait. If you need to say I'm sorry, don't hesitate. Don't wait to call your mama if she's this side of heaven's gate. Don't waste another day, for heaven's sake. And if you haven't trusted Jesus, don't wait. You might hold a grudge that's justified, but that grudge can't help your heart get right. Forgiveness always heals the soul, brings back that peace the devil stole. That old clock just keeps on ticking, the hourglass runs out. Make the most of every minute, 'cause all we have is now. If you wanna say I love you, don't wait. If you need to say I'm sorry, don't hesitate. Don't wait to call your mama if she's this side of heaven's gate. Don't waste another day, for heaven's sake. And if you haven't trusted Jesus, don't wait any longer. He's been knocking on the door. He's prepared a home in heaven for everyone who calls him Lord. Only God knows what tomorrow brings. Don't waste another day, for heaven's sake. If you haven't trusted Jesus, don't wait. Don't wait. It's been my honor to be joined up here by Ben Isaacs and my wife, Brenda.
Thank you.
We've been married 37 years. This is April, isn't it?
This is April.
29 days from being 38 years.
Wow.
Looky there.
This is April.
This is April.
Wow.
We're quarantined until the 30th.
That's right. Oh. We're quarantined until the anniversary.
Well. All right, Ben. There you go.
There you go,
We're
Ben.
We're going to go on to the next song.
Yes. But it's been a blessing. Thank you, brother, for honoring me with your presence and me and Brenda. And
I love you both with all my heart, and it truly is an honor.
Thank you, sir.
To stand with you, each of you, and sing.
So. You know that we love you.
I know.
Yes. Yeah.
And I hope you know I love you.
Absolutely. Okay. And thank you, Brenda.
You're welcome.
For dressing up the scene here a little bit.
Yes.
And we want to thank once again Ed Leonard, Daywind, Justin, and Micah. And do we get one of these iPads as kind of?
I'm taking one. Yeah.
Well, there's
they've got
of.
Enough. They wouldn't miss them. I mean, it's just, geez.
That's right. But it's been a blessing to be here. We'll be praying along with everybody else. Mm-hmm. We know that the Lord has a plan. He looked down from eternity past and saw the coronavirus.
The coronavirus, yes. And this song is so fitting.
Yes, and he knows. And we can trust him because of all the times in the past he's proven faithful.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's not blind faith. It's his word has proven to be true over and over again. And in our personal lives, his word has proven to be true, and he has proven to be faithful
mm-hmm.
over and over again. And he has a plan, and we'll just keep looking to him and staying 6 feet apart. We read in 1 Thessalonians 4:16, Jesus will come down in the cloud and blow that trump. And those who are dead in Christ will rise first. And those who are alive will rise and join Jesus in the cloud to live with him. How long, Ben? Forever.
Forever.
Amen. No more cancer. No more coronavirus. No more disease or separation or death. No more knee replacements. We read in Revelation that there'll not even be a sun, S-U-N, because Jesus Christ, the Son, will light up the universe. We'll be praying for each of y'all, and we would ask that you pray with us. And we would love to see you this side of heaven, but we'd rather meet you in the air. And until then, God bless you. Alive this morning on this side of the dirt. I don't take one day for granted while God walks me on his earth. If I take my last breath tonight and the good Lord takes my soul, they'll bury this old bag of bones down in some old dark hole. But when Jesus stands up on that cloud, makes that trumpet sound, I'll shed that coat and tie and leave that pine box in the ground. I'm a-coming up 6 feet, no grave gonna hold me. When good God Almighty calls from on high, brother, I'm a-gonna fly away, blaze of glory to the new place. I've already got the key, 'cause he rose on day three. I'm a-coming up 6 feet. Body, dance on streets of gold. No aches, all pains, none blind or lame. Nobody's growing old. I'll hear heaven's choir sing new notes I've never heard. I see mansions I've only imagined from God's word. Soon and very soon we'll see King Jesus split the sky. For the devil knows what happened in the blinking of an eye. I'm a-coming up 6 feet,
no grave gonna hold me. When good God Almighty calls from on high, brother, I'm gonna fly away, blaze of glory to the new place. I've already got the key, 'cause he rose on day three. I'm a-coming up 6 feet. If you knew he was coming any second, can you really say you're ready? There's room for everybody, but everybody got to confess and believe. I'm coming up 6 feet. No grave gonna hold me. When good God Almighty calls from on high, brother, I'm gonna fly away and blaze the glory to the new place.
Yeah,
I've already got the key. He's coming back for me. He knows where I'll be, 'cause he rose on day three. I'm coming up 6 feet. I'm coming up 6 feet. Coming up 6 feet. I'm coming up 6 feet. God bless y'all.